Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the stream. This is going to be a very interesting stream for a number of reasons. For one, I'm trying out Streamlabs OBS over here. I tried it out yesterday, and it was giving me some problems. So now I've got some new settings. I've got it down to ultra low, terrible quality settings. Just optimally designed for my computer. So quiet. Oh boy.
Hello, children.
I have a new, I have like compressors on now and like limiters, and I'm able to see the chat here in the sidebar of the Streamlabs thing instead of having to do like the YouTube thing, which is just terrible. Well, I don't know. Yesterday it was dropping frames. I'm hoping that today it does a little bit better, because this is going to be a very exciting stream, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take a dive into the tense, intense world. Okay, so hang on. The mic is okay now. Mic is too loud. Your mic too quiet. Okay. Is it the settings making you sound depressed? No, that's just my life. I'm actually pretty happy lately, but, you know, that's just a... You know, we're going from like minus 85 to like minus 60, you know, give or take. Let me see here. I have some filters going on here. People are telling me to turn the mic up a little bit. I'll do my best. Compressor. Let's pop that gain up to fucking... There we go. Let's try 10. How's that? How's that for you, folks? New mic, in case... New mic, who dis? In case you're not familiar, I bought a new mic. We used it in the new stream, in the stream yesterday about Gary Spivey. In fact, don't mind the ASMR here. I bought this foam thing to go on top of it, but I kind of don't like how muffled and weird my voice sounded last stream, so we're going to try without the foam from now. Turn it down a little low, turn it up better. You know what? We're going to leave it like this. I think it's going to be fine. So today we're going to be looking at NoFap and No Nut November. We're nearly halfway through. I'm very happy to say that I failed very quickly, and I'm very happy with what I failed to. Love you, baby. But we're going to be looking into NoFap, No Nut, people. Listen, here's the thing. Based on a very cursory glance at the whole NoFap thing, I feel like there's some decent points to it, at least. I feel like it's not 100% crazy. I feel like there's a kernel of truth somewhere in the idea of, you know, focusing on other things, trying to keep your mind on other tasks and passions and hobbies and things like that, focusing on your work, whatever. I can see where it could help some people. So I don't want to come off like I'm totally against this or whatever. I don't really know that much about this. I know a lot of people take it very, very seriously, which I find, unspeakably hilarious, but we'll get into that in a bit. But yeah, like, I know some people take it very seriously, but like, I don't know. I think there's something to be said for like a little bit of self-control, you know what I mean? I feel like there's something to be said for that. So I'm not going to, you know, completely shit on these folks just yet. I have never had the ability to do that. I've never wanted to, and I've never tried, and I'm okay with that decision. But you know, okay, you remember the Adpocalypse guy, Matt Watson? He was a NoFap guy, and look what it did for him. He wound up screaming at young girls on the street to appear in his adult video, but it's okay, because it was just for laughs, haha, just joke, just a prank, bro. And then he caused a bunch of people who make content to lose money for no reason other than pointless hysteria. So NoFap can work wonders for people, you know? Hats off to Matt Watson. Wonderful lad. Easy clap. But yeah, let's take a look here. We're going to be looking into, first of all, oh God, can I even do this? I don't even know if I'm set up to do this. Let's try it. Nope, didn't work. Hang on. I have scenes now. I never bothered with the scene thing before, but now I have scenes. And, now it's not actually allowing me to look at any, okay. Now I'm not able to, okay, wonderful. Welcome to Streamlabs OBS, where it still does the thing where I'm, like, weirdly not able to capture Firefox for whatever reason. Okay. Nice. Epic. Very epic. Right, so, hello. Hi. We're gonna go back to the bear. There we go. Yeah, I have scenes now. Little mini fade transitions. I'm just gonna go ahead and reopen Firefox, you know? No, not from Super Mega. Everybody thinks it's Matt Watson from Super Mega, and I love that, because that means that like a week after his little thing blew up on YouTube, everybody forgot who he was. And now the only thing anybody thinks of when they hear the term the name Matt Watson is this other guy who I've never fucking heard of, to be honest. But I'm sure he's a much better individual than the Matt Watson we know and love. But let's see here. Now the laptop needs work. Yeah, I would not mind a new laptop. That is true. Well, no, this is so much better than my last laptop, because people think that I started streaming just because it's like easier than doing videos or something, which is, I mean, kind of true. It's certainly more fun just interacting with folks instead of like laboring over Adobe Premiere and then losing 5 hours of work, because even though I manually saved it, it just decided that those past 5 hours of saves didn't really count. I didn't really feel it in my heart, you know? So I won't lie that that's certainly more fun than video editing, but no, I would have been streaming from the very start, but I had a laptop that's even worse than this one. So there's your reason. Was I the only one who lost NoFap about an hour into it? No, Bane, don't worry, you're not alone. No, we're still not. Okay, good. Okay, I am not able to capture. Right, very good. Very, very nice and hot. Okay, we're gonna remove that. There we go. Gonna pop in a new window capture. And we're gonna hope that this new window capture actually, there you go, it did it. It found the window. Very good. And it's also, oh god. And it's got a white bar on the top. Hang on, hold the fort. Okay, we need to do a filter. We need to throw on a crop, and then we go like, what is it? Top? Is it minus? I think it's minus. Yeah, no, it is not minus. It is plus. 7. There you go. No more white bar. See, I'm on the fly technical work. Okay, so we're gonna be oh, hang on. Can y'all take a look at the, can y'all see my favorites bar here? Because I don't know if, or my bookmarks or whatever. This is my folder of weird shit. I don't know if Streamlabs OBS shows this, but old OBS doesn't. I should take a screenshot sometime well, it would be like multiple screenshots, because this shit is getting intense. I tried to like keep it narrowed down a bit in the beginning, but like I had folders, but fuck that. This is I don't have the organizational thing within me. But here we go. Get a new grip on life. r/nofap. All right. Now, oh, fuck off, Dashlane. Alright, so we're gonna go to new. Now, I briefly skimmed this before, and I also had No Nut November, r/No Nut November, bookmarked. But they seem to take it a little bit more humorously than the NoFap community. The NoFap community is many years old. They're very serious about this. So, you know, I think there's actually a marked difference between the No Nut November people, which is kind of more of a meme than anything, and the NoFap people. But I'm just going to heartlessly lump it all into the same category because, you know, I'm a YouTuber and that's just what I do. Let me just take a look here. I hate Reddit's layout, even the old layout. Yeah, no thanks. Get a new grip on life. Fapstronauts. No, yeah, you're right. You are indeed correct. I lost at NNN when I rewatched the Vore stream. Oh, boy. $20 from Lol Nah. Of course, when I finally catch a live one, I can't stay for it. Take my money instead, Claw. Well, thank you very much, sir. And thank you for being the seminal first super chat that I can actually... Oh, hey, is my fucking screen... Is my screen fucked up? Oh, God. Is my... Oh, no. Oh, here we go again. thank you for being the first super chat that I can actually see in my Streamlabs OBS thing instead of on... hang on. There you go. I think that needs to be up there. Instead of on the YouTube dashboard, which is just terrible. The YouTube dashboard used to be kind of okay. I didn't mind it. I mean, it was better than whatever new fucking YouTube dashboard they're trying to shove down my throat, but... it was fine. And now it's like they've crunched the screen or something, and it's like all of the fields are cut off artificially, and where the super chat thing is, you just cannot read the last one that shows up. You're just not able to read it. Can we stretch this to screen? There we go. That's a little better. Could you get a second monitor finally? No, I do not even have the room for a second monitor, Bane. I'm running out of room for books and Switch games and McFlurry cups. Don't eat McDonald's, kids. All right, so this is r/nofap. It's been 90 days. We're sorting by new, and we're gonna see just what the NoFap community has for us. First of all, the description here: we host rebooting challenges in which participants,
Fapstronauts,
abstain from pornography and masturbation for a period of time. Whether your goal is casual participation in a monthly challenge as a test of self-control, or whether excessive masturbation or pornography has become a problem in your life and you want to quit for a longer period of time, you will find a supportive community and plenty of resources here. You know, see, on the surface, this doesn't sound so bad, right? Like, because I get it, you know? For some people, this kind of thing, it can get... Hey, it's the internet. It's fucking infinite. Imagine like, you have infinite possibilities. Of course some people are going to take that a little too far. So I can see how this could potentially help some people who, you know, need to, like, exercise some self-control and, like, take back that part of their life or whatever. But, well, I don't know. We'll just see. I don't know. We'll see. We'll make our decision as we go here. Let's see. I guess we should just let's see 90 days here. What's 90 days up to? So that'll make tomorrow day 91. Keep on trucking. Did you get women attraction? Well, obviously it's been 90 days, so I'm going to say I don't know. What's like I guess the fap thing is kind of like that's the important part of it. Like, it's not about like the actual nut part. Like, No Nut November is less specific, and it's like, well, what if, does this count if it's actual sex? I don't know, but I guess not. But the name No Nut November doesn't imply good things. But like the fap thing, you know, that's like an act of, well, like, That's like self-gratification, I guess. And it's like you saying, no! This is not right. This does not stand up.
In the light.
Okay, enough prog rock nonsense. Week 2. What do we got here? We'll have I have full control over my dreams now, and I am now a lucid dreamer. Well, good job, dude. I tried to learn how to lucid dream, like, years ago when I was, like, a teenager. And, I gotta be honest, you know, I had it once, by mistake. All I needed to do was just wait 2 weeks. You know, that never occurred to me, and honestly, I don't think the trade-off is worth it. Question to all the guys who've maintained a 90-day streak. How many days does it take, on average, for the urges to start to get weaker, and NoFap starts to get easier? Haven't hit 90 days, but hopefully can share some helpful info. Yes. Anyways, it all depends on your addiction. For some people, being able to conquer even a day is the hardest part. Then it gets easy. For others, it might take a week. Psychologically speaking, breaking from most addictions does take that 90-day mark. That's for a full reset. All right. Well, okay. Full 90 days. Any more, any less, it's not going to be right. Day zero. What's going on here? Journaling to stay motivated till hardest part of NoFap fades away. Day zero? If you can't go one day, dude, then that's... I mean, that's not even one day. That's zero. That's one zeroth of a day. Okay. Rambling post. Alright, here we go. A good one. A big, long one.
I don't know if this is the right place to post this, much less I don't know if anyone will find any of this interesting, but I feel the need to scream out into the void of the internet to vent my frustrations. I am someone who usually feels uneasy without making any sort of progress in life, whether that be working on a project or improving myself. Even on my worst NoFap streaks and worst weeks of progress in general, I at least knew that drive was always there. Yet within the past 3 weeks or so, I have consistently failed in my endeavors. Not just NoFap, but other things that I'm doing alongside it to try and improve myself, such as diet, consistent exercise, limiting my online media consumption, etc. Unlike the past, where I would take these failures and confront them head-on like a lion, I have little to no inspiration to pursue these disciplines or projects. My "I get knocked down, but I get up again" mentality is fading. Why? I don't know. Maybe it's because I feel alone in my journey as of late. I know that in reality there are thousands, maybe even hundreds of thousands, who have been working as hard, if not harder than me, but in my immediate surroundings, I don't see people like that. Someone can run alone for a very long time, but if they feel like giving up, fall, or get hurt, it helps to have someone alongside you. Mind you, I'm not saying I need someone to take me over the finish line. I think, is he looking for like an Obi-Wan? Is this a call to action for a mentor? A mentor-sturbator? Okay, maybe it's because I feel aimless in life. I keep educating myself, strengthening myself, keeping myself disciplined. I'm going and going and going, but towards what? I have a desire to make something of my life, but what is that something? What is even part of that something? Maybe there's some other cause that I'm not considering. Who knows? Part of me thinks that I should go to therapy to get something sorted out. But it's only been after I walked away from therapy along with a porn addiction group that I was able to start solving my problem. I look back and I know that this was a wise decision. I was treating both as a way to trick myself into thinking I was making progress. The more I just talk about my problems to people, the more they'll go away. I was fully embracing the idea of needing someone to carry me over the finish line without even knowing. This finish line stuff is starting to sound like, yeah, baby. Yeah. Carry me over that finish line, baby. Yeah. Oh, put the beans on it. All right. So before I sign off, major, minor ways. Take comfort in the fact that you're not alone and someone understands you a bit. Yeah, this is definitely a rambling post. Okay, that's ultimately pointless, but thank you, sir. How do I get the balls to take cold showers? No, the point is you lose your balls. That makes it way easier. No fat benefits are real, and an important P.S. everyone has to read. Okay, well, he told us everyone has to read it, so, you know, I have to comply. Hey, y'all, Scott here. First of all, I'd like to thank all of the fellows in this community, motivating everyone struggling with their addiction. I'm on day 25, and yes, I say the benefits are for real. Some of the benefits I've noticed due to NoFap are my confidence. No doubt it's through the roof. I've been taking cold showers, and my hair is getting stronger, and my skin is smooth. I've lost my tummy fat, and I've started to lose fat and gain muscles. Muscles. My veins on hand, forearm, are much more visible now. My voice has got a bit deeper, and I feel confident when I talk. Manly fine voice, ladies and gentlemen. Please introduce manly fine voice. Yes, yes. To be honest, female attraction is true. I've noticed 4 to 5 women are hitting on me and have started to flirt with me. Okay, guy. I can sleep better now. Earlier when I was addicted to PMO, and brain couldn't sleep till I watched porn, and I have completely got rid of this problem now. To be honest, I got a text from a girl while I was typing this post. She's a real girl, guys. She's got boobs and everything. Wow. 7, no more brain fog, and I'm looking forward for a wonderful journey, and I badly want to gain more benefits. P.S. It is an humble request from my side to all those who are posting that NoFap is not worth to not post such idiotic things and demotivate others. It may take some time for you to It may take some time for you people to progress. Don't give up or post idiotic posts. Live and let live. Does it count when I fuck up reading when this guy fucks up writing it? I don't know. And yeah, if you feel like there's no benefit from NoFap, that's fine. But you certainly know the harmful effects of PMO, and at least try to avoid that. Thanks, y'all. All right, one comment. Well done, guy. Keep it up. I'm doing the same. It's hard, but really worth it. All right, well, you know, again, I feel like there's some benefits to it. You know, don't let me get too, you know, far off the... I'm not bashing anybody here. This is not a bully stream. I know YouTube's new guidelines are... in full fucking force. This is definitely not anything close to it. I was going to talk about black Israelites today, but fuck that. I am going to go to D-Live or some shit for that. I don't know. Was wondering if erotic stories is as unhealthy as porn. Advice, please. Just had a quarrel with my GF. Anyone have experience with dealing with addiction to cross-dressing and sissy porn? Okay. And on this note, let me jump over here and take a look at the super chats once again. Very easily within... Oh, look at that fade out. Oh, that's great. Very easily within Streamlabs, I can check this. And I can see that Xander Darlow has super chatted Czar14. I don't know what a czar is, but thank you, sir. I lost No Nut November when I joined this live stream. Thank you, sir. Jay DeFeer Low has super chatted 5 pounds. I failed No Nut November on day 1. No shame. I've got some glare on my screen. Hang on. Spooky Nerdy Skellington has with $2. I speed ran No Nut November and nutted at 12 a.m. November 1st. Very good. Very nice. Premenstrual orgasm. I assumed it was like premature orgasm, maybe, but I guess it's something else. I think that's probably also an issue for them. Oh yeah, we have a thing now that shows the super chats on the screen. Is that showing up on the Firefox? When I have the Firefox open, we got $24.99 from Mia Smith. Your channel is real cool, man. Hope you're having a nice day, bro. I'm having a very nice day, Mia Smith, and I hope you have a lovely day as well. Thank you very much. Czar is South Africa. Oh, well, good luck to you, my friend. Being a sad boy failure is more pathetic than being a confident failure. Just do 100 push-ups a day. You know, that's a good tip, honestly. Czar is a Russian emperor. Urban Dictionary PMO, please. You know, someday we'll do an Urban Dictionary stream because wow, is that some kind of fucking sight? It has been around for a long time, and all of those edits from 2000 are still there.
My fucking edits from 2000 are still there.
Alright. Let's, only with the bear, not on Firefox screen. Oh no. We'll pop over to browser here again. It should be working. I don't know. I'm not sure why it's not, everything should be fine, but, only with the bear. Well, that's unfortunate. You know, at least that's some kind of step up from what we had before. I'll figure it out next stream. So, anyone have experience with dealing with addiction to cross-dressing / sissy porn? I asked this 2 weeks ago and only got one response, no, without any suggestions or help or advice. I'm throwing out my cross-dressing clothes and deleting my porn collection. I'm sorry, no jokes, not a bully stream. I started on NoFap the other week, but I got lonely, so I started drinking. After the drinks set in, I got horny, and my inhibitions had me order a bunch of cross-dressing clothes online. Now, doesn't that just mean female clothes? It turned into an almost week-long fap fest till I was extremely drained and realized how stupid this was. I'm going to try to start over and not do any drinking, too. I'm really struggling with the loneliness. The end goal is I want to start dating and be normal. I want normal sex to be a desire, not some twisted fantasy. They say you can't change if you don't want it. I want it. So I'm throwing away $1,000 worth of clothes and shoes that I used in cross-dressing over the years. Deleting a very large porn collection. Trying to untrain my mind to be into weird porn. Advice would be great, and if you went through this. Yeah, I mean, good luck with that shit, dude. No comments there, because, I need help, sad face. Oh, D colon. I've been doing PMO. Okay, I think we need to know what PMO is. Hang on. What's going on here? What's going on here? What's PMO? Office of the Prime Minister. Okay, well, that's good. We know who that is. We know what that is now. I've been doing the Office of the Prime Minister since my freshman year of high school, around December. I'm a senior now. Recently, I've tried to really put an effort to quitting, but nothing seems to work anymore, and I don't know. I just want to cry. I've been taking cold showers. I've been exercising. I've been trying to stay motivated, but I just keep failing. I can only make it to 3 days, and if I try really hard, I can make it at most to 4 days, but nothing more. Yeah, dude, you're like a fucking senior in high school. No shit. What's wrong with you? I hate porn, and it's just killing me, and I'm so addicted to it that I have to... Well, okay. I mean, yeah. Like, again, when you know you've got a problem, it's like, all right. I can't blame you too much, but it is kind of fucking hilarious. I don't understand, because I've been doing most of what you guys suggested for like 3 to 4 weeks now, and I've made zero progress except for 2 streaks that I made to 4 days. Progress isn't constant, dude. There will be weeks where you stay at the same streaks and relapse, and then suddenly it goes up. Progress is bumpy road. Accept it. Don't think you are failing, for one. Alright, well, cool. You know, I don't know how good I feel about reading this high school seniors fucking fat journal, but day 27, I binged porn before bed without masturbating. Ended up having a wet dream. How much did I hurt my progress? No other part of the comment here. You did not hurt it too much. Continue and avoid porn max. This is where the incel thing starts to like bleed into this. If you're not aware, there's a bit of an incel crossover to some extent. And they sure love to put the fucking word max at the end of everything, which I'm sure has nothing to do with why nobody wants to be around them, because that's not fucking annoying at all. Don't throw away a good streak. As long as you stay porn free and don't fap, you're good. Fap, you're good. Okay. Mm-hmm. Continue doing no fap. You failed, sure. How did he fail? It was completely out of his control. I would say that's a success in my book. Never, never, never give you up. Never give up. You can do it. We either make ourselves miserable or we make ourselves strong. The amount of work is the same.
A quote by Carlos Castaneda. I thought of it after relapsing and after seeing it again in the comments section of an unrelated YouTube video.
It's true.
Something to think about. 14 years old here, just wanting to start out. I took a wank about... Uh-oh. I don't know if I like this fucking Reddit. I think I might... No, this is not good. I wonder how many other people are involved in this Reddit who know about the young age of some of these people who maybe are there to talk to them about it and coach them through it, you know? I wonder how many people are here for that. Not making any accusations. Yes, I fucking am. This isn't, like, a person. This fucking subreddit can't sue me. Somebody on this fucking subreddit is here because there's 14-year-olds and high school seniors and shit. I don't like this one. I do not... Okay, does your NoFap include a significant other, I'm guessing? Is it literally hands-off for everyone? But I don't PMO on my own. I assume that includes Fab. I don't edge or anything, nah. So he just doesn't touch his cock at all? Like, what's the... Where do we draw the line here? Because, like, any stimulus could be construed as, like, you know, day one. Have I failed? Yes. Lil Nut. This is from you/Lil Nut. So I dreamt a dream last night. You dreamt a little dream, have you? Where I were super horny. I wasn't aware that it was a dream at the time and tried pushing away the urge to fap, but it didn't work, so I tried edging. Unfortunately, that did work. Or that did, of course, not work, and it resulted in me PMOing. Then I woke up with the hardest boner of my life, but couldn't find any trace of any cum. I was relieved to find out that I hadn't PMO. What's with the... Why is there now a fucking colon in there? Is that part of the... Okay. We're gonna have to find out what PMO is again. We're gonna have to look this up. Because I as much as I'd like to pretend it's the office of the Prime Minister, PMO, NoFap. Porn, masturbation, orgasm. Why would you ever call it that, you fucking weirdos? Holy shit. Okay, fine. Have I failed? What is this? Oh yeah, he dreamt a little dream. And this guy's right. He doesn't have any control over that. I would plus one you, but fuck no. Streak stopped a few days ago and doesn't continue to count. Had a dream where I relapsed. Now that counts. I am posting this because I feel like it could help someone. Just some thoughts I had before going to sleep. Feeling sloppy. What's going on here? Anyone ever wake up and you just feel sloppy? You aren't energetic, fully awake, and tired? I felt this way today, and it ended... Dude, that's every day of my life, and it ended with a relapse. Is there any way I can prevent that feeling? If I do get that feeling, what can I do to get rid of it? I always relapse when I get that feeling. I don't know what to do when I get it, either. Ignore the feeling. Who cares about feelings? You are not a slave to your feelings. You are stronger than that. You are powerful.
You are a strong, independent woman.
You are the master over yourself. You're not helpless. You are free. It's the truth. All right. Well, I mean, that sounds pretty definitive then. How do you stop this curse? Sounds like some fucking metal lyrics. I feel very down. Can you guys help me out? I don't intend to bring anyone down, smiley face.
You can trust me, smiley face.
How do you stop this curse if you've been addicted for 10 years?
If you can't have sex before marriage because of your religious views. If you got anxiety and depression.
If you know that this destroyed you mentally and physically but still do it. If this destroyed your image about women but you still do it. If this caused you hard, flaccid... But you still do it. Hard, flaccid? What does that mean, like hard all the time? Oh, God. But you still... What to do if you feel lonely and need some... But...
Listen, friend. I think you need the dating advice Reddit, not this one. Sweet boy.
If you fucking wake up at night for no reason and can't sleep, what do you do?
You don't need intimacy each day.
I think you should find something you're passionate about. Maybe start going to the gym and make some friends. Then you'll be a part of a community and can go from there. You work on yourself, simple as it is.
Yeah, like, I can kind of get this guy. This guy's kind of right. You do everything you have to. Work out, wash your dishes, discipline yourself. I kind of get that. It's like, I'm going to stop doing this. This is going to be, like, the symbolic, like, the buck stops here. Like, all of the bullshit. We're going to cut all the bullshit. We're going to not, like, sit around playing video games and watching Jeopardy. We're not going to do any of the dumb shit that we've been doing or fapping. And we're going to cut that stuff out, and we're going to instead focus on working on ourselves. I can kind of see how that's, like, you know, a decent idea, but it's just that I know that some of the people, well, my opinion, yes, at NoFap on Twitter, instead of just leaving us alone to focus on recovery, the porn industry and certain allies have decided to launch a smear campaign. Campaign of defamation and smears against us and our founder. Who the fuck is their founder? We've generally tried to ignore their attacks, but they've been escalating.
Word has come in from the Pornhub encampment. They're rallying their forces, my general. What shall we do?
Prepare the planet smasher.
All right. Well, this is the kind of thing that I'm talking about. This is a little bit overly dramatic, if you ask me. What are the comments to this look like? Yes! No matter what comes our way, we shall diligently hustle through our... Hustle? Interesting choice of words, friend. Through our obstacles and move further. We shall smash each and every goal, no matter how big...
Yes, each and every goal, ma'am.
No matter how big or small it is, our biggest enemy can't be something outside of us, but rather some negative emotions that are hidden deep within. If our wings are cut... But bro... Listen, fella, hard A fella, we shall always rise with wings of fire, for we are Phoenix, which always rise from the ashes. Writing this while on my 20... Okay, wow, this is... I mentioned before something sounded like metal lyrics, but I'm pretty sure these are straight from Symphony X. Fly with me! Alright, things are getting exciting. Now you have my attention. On Twitter... people mock those that want to get away from porn. It really shows that the enemy isn't only the porn industry.
The enemy, guys.
But the current culture itself. Bottom text. That don't value self-control over destructive behavior. They don't recognize it as destructive. A lot of people still don't believe eating and gaming addiction should be classified as a real addiction. It will take time. Well, anything can be an addiction. You could be addicted to fucking books. You could be addicted to Cheetos, you know, anything. Well, that's eating, but, like, you could be addicted to, like, collecting fucking pogs. I don't know. This happens every year. Let's go! Okay. Let's give the client a shot here. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, man, I gotta catch up a bit. Let's fly back to the bear. We got $5 from Zombie Seagull. First time catching your streams live. Keep up the great work. Cheers from... Okay, I'm... Can I please... Hang on. Please let me read. New Orleans. Okay, I'm sorry. This is still not a perfect technology. It's taken a while to... It's getting cut off. But Project... thank you very much. Project Noble... has super chatted $2 crawling in my skin. I might NUT for real. Spooky. Thank you. Spooky Nerdy Skellington has super chatted $2. I added you on the Discord with what PMO means. Well, thank you, sir, but I think we figured it out. I think it means porn / masturbation / orgasm, which I guess is like meant to be like the sequence of events that counts as the. But it, to me, it's just, like, what's defined by porn? Like, does, like, your girlfriend's nudes count as porn? Do like, pictures of dead animal carcasses count as porn? You know what I mean? Like, it's a bit of a weird, I don't know, I feel like just calling it FAP is a little bit easier, but,
But yeah, thank you, Mr. Skellington. Takao Nokash with $5. Your streams always make me feel normal again. Enjoy these shekels, Claw. Thank you very much, sir. At least you don't have, like, again, no hate to some people who are maybe doing this, but I guess I would just say that, like, I don't know. At least you haven't got to the point where this is, like, a mandatory thing that you need to do to be able to, like, live with yourself. You know what I mean? So, you know, at least there's that. Thank you, sir. Abigail English with $4.99. Please heal my jaw pain and 38% grade in biology 110L with NoFap. All roads lead to Smurf abuse. You're not wrong. Make sure to check out, make sure to watch out for Vic George under your beds, ladies and gentlemen. This applies to kids and adults. No one is safe, allegedly. Steve Cox thank you, Abigail. Steve Cox with $2. I nutted in my shorts from jogging yesterday. Exactly. Like, this is, you know, anything can happen. Like, you need to, I guess that's why the PMO term exists, but I mean, even still, it's I don't know. Thank you, Steve. Mia Smith with $14.99.
Nutting!
Thank you. And Project Noble with $2. RRU. SSU, yes. I can't wait to get my entire channel demonetized when I have no videos on my channel. That's going to be fun. It's going to be pretty fun. Thanks at Meme Review. There's someone in chat named...
Attention all YouTube users! Markiplier announced that YouTube is banning all viewers for using emotes as spamming. No spamming emotes or get banned from YouTube.
Thank you, Meme Review. Attention all Fortnite gamers! Default number one needs your... three digits, those three wacky digits on the back of your parents' credit card. Thanks, kids. All right, let's get back in the action here.
Finish the fight.
All right, so I don't know how much longer we want to look at this Reddit. It looked a little more interesting before because this one here, this is actually a pinned message. This is like the highest message on the thing. So this is what you see when you walk in to r/nofap, but I don't know, most of it is just like, hey, day two, you know, weekly updates, what reason did you start nofap? Oh, this ought to be good. What do we got here? I've been addicted to porn throughout my entire teenage life, what made me a very shy, antisocial, and insecure guy. For years, I just thought, I'm just like that, what can I do? Then I met nofap, and I finally learned that I needed to stop. So I can get girls. I don't know if it's a good reason or not, but it's the truth.
I realized that porn, masturbation, and degeneracy overall was a negative impact on my life.
I literally just started today. I watched a video of the history of No Nut November. Is this the fucking one from Wavy Websurf? I think he literally just fucking posted that like an hour before my stream, so I think I need to watch that immediately after because I honestly don't know the history of No Nut, and Wavy Websurf is a wonderful chap, so I need to check that one out, and you guys probably should too if you want to know more about this thing. I'm just going into what the culture of No Nut, but and NoFap, but. I think Wavy Websurf's video probably will go into more of the history of it, but I don't know if this is the one. But he watched a video on the history of it and heard of some of the benefits. I thought I'd give it a shot and see if any changes happen. I'm not that set on going for years of not fapping like some people. That seems too unnecessary for me. But nonetheless, I'm giving it a shot. Plus, it adds a challenge for me. Edit. Grammar. You see, before, if he was masturbating, like, chronically, he would not have edited his grammar. It would have just been disgusting. You would have found, like, your instead of you are. It would have been the worst thing ever. To improve sport performance and basketball. I mean, good luck, bro. There was that dude in the Super Chats who went off in his shorts the other day. So, you know, more power to you. I suffer from postcoital tristesse. Hey, Tristan, we found your future wife. I get really sad after I masturbate. Wow, that's unfortunate. Postcoital tristesse. No, not November, and reading its benefits. Improving health, changing mindset, becoming less socially awkward with people. Having GF in the process would be nice as well. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to lie, that would make it a lot easier. That does, in fact, make this month. This month is just flying by, baby. I felt guilty, and I wanted to become a better self. I felt like crap afterwards and regret it. What are you guys up to? You know what I mean? Like you probably shouldn't be filled with regret, you know? Like, no regretty, all spaghetti. 1 week, no fap.
Intense urges.
But physical strength has improved. You know, plus one to strength. Minus three to sanity. So today and yesterday have been pretty hard. I've already had a couple sexual dreams. Don't think I came. But I was lifting weights this morning, and holy shit. I feel like resisting sexual urges really pays off at the gym. I was lifting heavier than usual, but it didn't feel that heavy at all. I'm also feeling pretty energetic, and I didn't drink. Wasn't there a fucking Seinfeld episode about this? This was just about the whole process in general, because George was, like, addicted to, you know, chasing after, like, women to have sex with them. Which is unrealistic, considering it's George, but, I mean, I can see why he would be addicted to it, at least. But, yeah, he decided to stop having sex with his girlfriend, and he was just, like, becoming smarter and shit. I think fucking Seinfeld predicted. I think this whole thing is Seinfeld's fault. Jerry Stanfield, motivated for a reboot. Didn't drink any coffee today. I've noticed the same things. My strength is noticeably a bit better. I mean, well, yeah, you don't have to expend all your arms' energy doing other things. I can see how that might be. Day 10 of NNNL.
Stay strong, boys.
What's L? What is an L? You're the L, forehead. Warning/truth. There is a user on here with the name of GSP Greases. He constantly says that it is inevitable that people relapse and people are helpless to temptation. Do not listen to that bullshit. With every action people make, whether it is going to take a shower, going to work, working on homework, people are always in control of themselves. We always choose what to do at every moment. We are not puppets or robots. Okay, here we go. Or slaves to anything. We are absolutely free to live our lives however we wish. We will not be bound by their shackles and chains! We will lash back against our oppressors! I am going to need to go and get a water in a couple minutes. We are masters over ourselves. It is completely realistic that we can go the rest of our lives without ever okay, guy. I know that my dad used to be an alcoholic, but he hasn't drank in over 20 years. If someone can completely give up drinking for life, why not the same for you have no I'm gonna go with what this gut with what cerebral gut flora says. Just lol. I agree, lol. Please
help.
41 days. It's my 40th day. For the last 3 to 4 days, I noticed that sperms are coming out along with my urine. And oh my god, and I'm also experiencing itching. Though a very little one when I'm about to finish my pee. I think the itching is only because sperm are coming out and not anything else. Is no gap to do with this? Yeah, you know, you gotta swear off Gap products. They're just not ethical. Or I seriously may have some issue. Some experienced NoFap members. Nah, not fapping. Nah, not for me. Member may be of help. It's just your body releasing sperm. It's common enough, I think. Yeah, I mean, when you're at the point where even your body is like, bro, listen. Hey, guy, listen. Hey, get me out of here. I'm not done, you know, like, it's like, listen to what your body has to tell you, dude. Where is the PDF behind an email? I have problems with FAP, internet, and games. I need help. I have no control over my life. It's 4 a.m. and I'm making chocolate pudding. Not anymore. I was alone at home. 3 day. And what did I do? I spent time... Man, it is hard to talk. I spent time on video games and YouTube. I was fighting also my porn addiction. I didn't won. Guys, he didn't won. F's in chat. I cannot even be concentrated while I read. You know, hang on. I better go check the chat to make sure we're not actually effing. Is everything all right? Is everything good? Hold the fort. Yeah, everything seems to be okay. Go ahead. F as much as you like, folks. These people sure as fuck aren't. I cannot even be concentrated while I read. I don't want to finish like those type of people that you see around sometimes and you think, he's weird. I don't want to spend time and energy on video games and fapping. I cannot take this anymore. I don't want anything like this anymore. I have problems with studying. I procrastinate a lot. I have problems with friends and social... I mean, yeah, but it's 2020 almost. Like, of course you do. We're in a fucking dystopia, mate. Like... Watch the Frederick Knudsen video about the mouse utopia experiments, and you'll understand. You'll understand just what's wrong with us, and problems with girls. I would really like to be the same as before. Read a lot of books or go out with or without friends. I like how he capitalizes the F in friends. So we're not quite sure if he means his friends or like a box set of the show. And now I even broke my PC screen for my anger. Okay. All right. Wow. That's definitely a problem that you have, sir. You know, you might not want to ask Reddit about this. You might want to go to a fucking, like, shrink. I don't know. You need a plan of action with plenty of healthy habits to get yourself out of this cycle, my friend. You are not alone. We're all fighting this struggle. I find exercising, socializing, and meditation help me a lot. Be careful, though. Meditation is pretty close to a different M word. Big flatline. 132 days? Hey, guys. These past 2 days have been in a big flat... Dude, you're 132 days in, mate. You can keep going. Shut the fuck up. You're fine. Probably the biggest I've had in so long. I woke up feeling really sad and depressed. And I haven't been sad or depressed since February when I started my first streak. But yeah, this flatline is really bad. I woke up, cried for some reason. I don't know if it's because I watched the movie Little Manhattan last night, because that made me feel sad. I don't know what movie that is, but I'm sorry, sir. I hope you feel better now. But yeah, I hope it ends soon. I wonder if you've got a girlfriend yet with all that increased attraction from women and whatnot. On a 132-day streak, you still get flatlines. Thought it'd be over faster. Nah, dude, it's never gonna fucking end. You're not like a fucking... Maybe these people just are trying to, like, train to become, like, amateur fucking, like Tibetan monks, you know what I mean? Like, Buddhist monks. They're trying to become, like, self-made eunuchs or some shit. We got this one here that looks exciting. I'm done with this dumb shit! From 82 days. I'm sick of this shit. I just relapsed. And I can't do this anymore. I'm so done. Fuck porn. I will never watch it again. It's disgusting and filthy. It's against my religion and it objectifies women and men into things for personal pleasure. And I will not be a part of that any longer. I know you guys probably see posts like this every day, but I seriously need to rant. I need to discipline myself starting from right now. I will never watch porn again. I will update everyone. Well, you're 82 days in. You're 82 days in. I think you've already made that choice, mate. Maybe he's just accidentally 82 days in. Maybe he just doesn't go that often, but he's so committed to not doing it that... Oh, boy. I don't know if I... Anytime you mix religion with this shit, it just starts getting a little bit questionable. Jehovah Witness. Lamau, no, I'm Muslim. Uh-oh. Not a bully stream. Never... Okay. It's first day of NoFap, and I'm excited about it. You're excited? Well, I'm having intense blue balls. You're excited. Why would you be excited? Damn right you should be, my friend. It can be the start of a great journey. Hello, darkness, my old friend. All right, well, I'm debating on joining NoFap. Friends trying to hook you up with girls while you're on a reboot. Today I felt off. Considering NoFap, any tips? 10 days of NoFap? My testicles hurt. Wait, aren't you the same guy who just posted, I'm having intense blue balls? Dude, listen, your body is telling you what must happen. Started seeing particles and shit and hearing a really loud beep. Oh fuck, I didn't read that last part where you said joking. Did this man do it? Cold shower works pretty good. This man's balls are going to fucking explode because we're not built for this. Holy shit. This is from the same guy. As in the title, I'm now on only day 10? Alright, some people have gone like 132 days. You're just a little baby bitch. Almost relapsed, as the title suggests, my testicles really hurt, like they're being squeezed. Has anyone else had this? Does it have to do with the edging? If you're edging, yeah, what the fuck's wrong with you, dude? Maybe find question, but what are blue balls? When you masturbate and don't nut, stop edging. Don't edge. Don't ever edge again. Yeah, what the fuck, bro? Like, we found your problem. Don't dabble. Whatever you do, don't dabble, don't scrabble. I'm losing hope. NoFap, 2 weeks done. Yesterday I was screaming, I'm alive, in the middle of a grocery store. That's how hot. Oh, wow, okay. I'm alive. Bro, congratulations. You're going back to who you used to be before PMO. Yes, yeah, screaming in the middle of a grocery store, apparently. Okay. Great. Cool. Glad for you. That sounds like a real fucking turnaround for your life. Absolutely correct. It affects everything. To all guys who want success and peace, first stop, quit watching porn. It affects everything. Note that this guy used the right effects, but this guy didn't. This is what we need. We need more celebrities to highlight such issues. Terry Crews is big on the issue. No, only Nazis don't watch porn. I'm happy to be this kind of Nazi. Sieg Heil, then. What else should I say? Comment of the day, probably. Does it affect or effect everything?
Definitely.
Okay. Thanks. Written by a stand-up dude as well. Wait, what? He's a stand-up dude? Well, he's probably making a fucking joke. Oh, maybe you meant stand... Alright, well... You know, many of us probably discovered PMO in the 2010s. But what happens in the 2010s stays in 2010s. For the next decade and forever, bros. Wow, okay. How much has this really helped people? You know what I mean? Like, they're all in this community where they're, like, self-congratulating each other and going, like, yeah, dude, I'm, like, 200 days in and it's going great. I still don't have a girlfriend or a job. I still live in my mom's basement. But you know, I feel better. Like, okay. I mean, that's just pretty much just a placebo effect, I'm going to say. They know that if you quit PMO, they won't have you under their control anymore. We're getting they. We're bringing them into this. The daily... Oh, my God. Okay. Oh, God. This is so stupid. Yeah. This is satire. Am I right? I hope.
How did this crap make it on TV?
I mean, yeah. It's the Daily Show with fucking Trevor Noah, of course. You're not wrong, but...
First they mock.
Deceptions, lie, and deceit. And they brand Peterson the alt-right leader of Canada. Truly a clown world we live in. What is novirtualsex.com? Hang on, let me just go ahead and jump to black real quick, which I can now do. The list of greats, best of NoFap. Short guide to, okay, I think this is probably... Is this site okay? I don't know. We're in weird territory here, because Like, it's a certain type of discussion matter, but there's not really a lot of pictures. Probably because we wouldn't want to wind up like that one guy. But, okay, I think I can show this. But, actually, before I do, let's catch up on things here. What's going on? Tacone no cash with $2. Oi! I'm not one of these freaks! Exactly. You know, stop by Deadwing Dork's Stream Emporium, where, hey, at least you're not Movie Bob. Which is probably not going to get a part two, by the way. Movie Bob is so lame compared to some of the shit that I've talked about now. I am sorry if you're one of the folks who's waiting for Movie Bob part two, but I can't promise anything. It may happen someday, but I don't know, man. Movie Bob is so tame, but yeah, at least you're not Movie Bob, though. Thank you, sir. Ethan Alfasi with £2. Are we going to revisit Sonic for real justice? We've actually been talking about that. Some people asked earlier in the stream chat, and yeah, I mentioned it to Chris, and I said we might do it in the coming month or something like that. The main problem was that the first time we did it, the stream froze. Like my computer kind of fucked up when we got to a certain part in the Google Doc, and then. And then we tried it a week later, and my computer froze at the exact same part in the same Google Doc. So we're looking into some alternatives to that Google Doc. We'll maybe turn it into screenshots or something. We're not sure, but yeah, we may finish the fight at some point. Thank you, sir. AJS or AJ's Space Place has super chatted $4.99. Today is my 20th birthday, and now I'm watching your stream. I don't know if that makes this my best or saddest birthday. Well, you know, who's sadder, or you or the guy that you're watching? You know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't worry about it, sir. We're all sad. That's my secret, Cap. We're all sad here. We're always sad here. And at least you're not alone, you know? So I hope your birthday goes wonderfully, sir. Let me go. Smegma on demand with $5. These assholes just aren't used to not being in a perpetual state of post-ejaculation lethargy. Yeah, more or less. I love your name, by the way, Smegma on demand. I think these people could qualify for that too. Project Noble with $2. I wonder what r/incel looks like during NN. I mean, aren't the incel boards all, like, fucking boarded up on Reddit now? Aren't they, like, haven't they been yeeted the fuck off of there? Abigail English with $1.99. Edging is bad for your pelvic floor. I'll just have to take your word for it. But she sounds like she knows what she's talking about, so everybody be careful. No edge. Edge Sember, I don't know. That means no Shadow the Hedgehog either. I know a lot of you will have trouble not playing Shadow the Hedgehog during No Edge December, but you know, you're just gonna have to bear with us. So let's jump back into the best of NoFap. Put your energy to better use. Find the best motivating posts on NoFap and learn why internet porn and excessive masturbation is bad for you, period. So we can really take this to mean excessive masturbation is bad for you. Home, what is NoFap? Let's go to what is NoFap. Fap is a bit of internet vernacular slang for the act of self-love masturbation. Every day, a group of men and women around the world digitally congregate at a Reddit board called NoFap to specifically discuss not masturbating. NoFap is a challenge in which participants abstain from pornography or masturbation from a period of time on official NoFap on Reddit. Is this the same NoFap? Is this the one we were on? Yeah, this is the one we were on. There are currently more than... Well, that's not how you write numbers. Members of this community, they call themselves Fapstronauts because that's just exactly what the power of NoFap can do. It can make you think that the term Fapstronauts is like at all acceptable, and attribute a number of major life changes to the practice, such as increased confidence, concentration, motivation, libido, etc. For some, it's a means of addressing concerns with their porn consumption, while others see it as a healthy means to healthy relationships. Why? I think we get why. I don't know. This feels like just a resource. This is pretty boring. I think we're going to move on from novirtualsex.com. But hey, if you need to know the rules of NoFap, you know, this is probably a good resource for you. Let's move on here. Now before we do move on, though, I have to say, like, again, I get the concept of what they're talking about here. Like, I get what they're going for, the whole journey of self-improvement thing. I kind of understand that, but then you get people talking about, like, deceptions, lies, and deceit, and all this stuff. And, like, these people who are talking about Phoenix rising from the ashes and shit like that. Like, man, you're calling yourselves fapstronauts. You cannot possibly think that I'm going to take you this seriously. You cannot possibly be taking it this seriously yourself. Well, I guess when you're fucking not jerking off, you're going to be taking that pretty goddamn seriously. Never mind. I understand. NoFap is the truth. Okay. And anyone who tells you differently doesn't understand. NoFap is the way. All right. Well, we finally found it, ladies and gentlemen. Haven't fapped for several you know what? Actually, I am going to go run into the kitchen, grab a water real quick. Let me put you on hold for a moment. Just a sec. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. I have returned with the water. I have hydrated. And remember, daily reminder to hydrate. You must drink many cups of water per day. I don't know the exact number, but go out and get it, son. Haven't fapped for several months. Can't get an erection. Uh-oh. See, I'm seeing nothing but downsides to this. I'm seeing people with their fucking body parts exploding, and other people with them just deciding no longer to work. Hello, I stopped masturbating and stopped watching porn in July. For some time, I simply enjoyed the benefits on NoFap, but a few weeks ago, I discovered that I no longer can get an a few weeks? I'm 29, I don't drink alcohol, don't smoke, maintain a healthy diet, and have enough sleep. I don't masturbate or watch porn. Long since I've quit fapping, I also lost any desire for sex and rarely even think about it. What could go wrong? I believe this is a flat line. I'm on day 41-ish, and I haven't had some since I started my streak. As far as I'm aware, this is normal. So this guy's got no urges. Have you been on the Pied forum as well? What the fuck is this forum? I have a feeling we're about to go on this forum. What's going on here? I guess that's not gonna get us what we want. Well, shit. There are a lot of posts from other people about what you're experiencing. It's a good resource. A lot of times, if she just gets naked in front of you, it magically starts working again. Yeah, well, I don't think that's gonna help for this guy. Yes, it is normal. Your brain is rewiring. When you will get intimate with a real girl, your boner will be back.
Yeah, I don't know if this is exactly like that. I don't know if it's like, I don't know if it's like when you need the force, it will be there, or some like magical, like science fiction movie bullshit, but okay. I feel like you might just be breaking yourself. As soon as you get a chicky babe around your body. A chicky babe? Okay. God, now I'm scared to do this in hard mode. Oh, jeez. What is hard mode? Oh, no. What does that, like, just mean never looking at a female? Or maybe hard mode is with the edging. Oh, God. Does this count as ejaculator? You are not? What is this grammar?
Other night I had urges and started beating it, but I knew all my efforts will go to waste if I...
Well, this isn't even... This is just a fucked up title. He's not even got a weird accent. Ugh, okay. I haven't relapsed yet, but I'm gonna quit NoFap. No Nut November is a joke. From Johnny 119 Days over here. Okay, guy. Okay, gay. To us NoFap veterans. I have a different view. This is from Mr. 79 Days. I have a different view that I'm happy so many people are giving it a try for whatever reason. It may not be serious to some, but I notice a lot...
Yeah, it shouldn't be like a fucking lifestyle, bro. It should not be that. When you call yourselves fapstronauts, I don't think you should call... Okay, but people are controlling their addictions, and there's a problem going on with it. So why look down on them for it? My post was a joke, since NoFappers before No Nut November would already be on streaks and living a NoFap lifestyle, so No Nut November is just a normal month to them. I support N to the third power all the way. Nitrogen squared 3 is pretty cool, not gonna lie. I agree. Here's 70 days with show off. You're at 70 days, dude. Shut up. You're doing better than most people. Wet dream on day 29.
I peeked at porn.
What kind of porn are you peeking at there, buddy? I peeked at porn. I didn't touch myself, but a drop of cum was in my underwear. Have I failed? No, not November. Oh, my God. I feel like... Wow. Congratulations. You've relapsed. Well, you haven't failed NNN, I guess, but you have failed NoFap. Edit grammar. Okay. Better luck next time, bro. Block any source of porn you can have access to. Yeah, I mean... The porn part is a pretty important part of it, I would say. It's a lot of P's in a row. So is this subreddit. Third week of NoFap. Easy! Easy! Peasy. Alright. Failed. Help me. Third week of NoFap.
No sex?
Yeah, I think that's just how it is for most people. I've read many posts saying things like masturbating will
lower testosterone, create brain fog, lower your energy, make you have a hard time sleeping, and many more.
And many more is definitely my favorite part of that list, and I just don't see how these things would not apply to sex as well. Logically, if there are... No, I can see how it would not apply, because it's not the end result. It's not the destination. It's the journey. It's the friends we made along the way. I'm like, if you're not making any friends along the way, it's not a very good journey, you know what I mean? Like, I can see how there's a bit of a difference. Anyways, I'm 2 weeks into NoFap and confused by this problem. Because when you have sex, you feel with your partner. You gain the energy from the other person by having real sex. Oh, is that what the NecroZoo guy was talking about?
I'll be closer to God.
Well, I'm out. 0 days. I hope that's the current total. I thought edging myself was a good idea, but it clearly wasn't. Resetting after 10 days. But I'm not quitting. I'm gonna make it to December 1st. I need to stop looking at porn. Seriously, why the hell did I think that was a good idea? Anyone struggling, just know.
The nut doesn't feel good. You just feel awful as you fail.
Take that seriously. I read people saying that and mostly ignored it, but trust me.
You'll just feel awful.
I mean, he's right, you know. When you relinquish that, like, self-control, that goal, that's, you know, that's not good. Hey, don't beat yourself up. Many have fallen into the same trap. I'm not giving up. I felt so much more confident. Bro, edging is relapsing. Why don't many of you know this?
This dopamine hit is as destructive as the dopamine hit of nutting. Cut your access to porn, bro. Dopamine. That's a good name for, like, a mime troupe. That would be good. Start worrying about prostate cancer if you're a plus 50 virgin. Oh, God. Is that like a common concern in this community? Porn affect brain?
Porn affect brain! Brain bad, cause porn bad! Porn bad!
I asked in another category, but I saw that you are the most popular on this topic. Does pornography affect intelligence? I also want arguments. Of course it does. What is OFC? OFC? Okay, so OFC it does.
What is OFC?
I answered your question. Ah, of course. I thought it was something chemical.
Can you tell me how it affects? Brain.
This board is magical. This guy thinks OFC is like a chemical. Oh, this is wonderful. A specific area of the brain, the prefrontal cortex. This part of the brain is associated with decision-making and other activities. The studies show that porn addiction and other drug addictions have the same impact on this part of the brain. Yeah, brain bad, because porn bad. Hi, I got a question. Yeah, fuck off. Procrastination after wet dreams. Yo. My first double-digit streak in 2 years, and... Well, you can't just leave us on a cliffhanger like this. What's going on here? I don't know how long I could keep this up. I feel like a balloon, a ballon ready to pop, and it's killing me. It can't help but to edge, just to calm myself down a little. Any advice? Don't do it! Alright. Getting a little bored with the Reddit here, so... We're gonna take a peek over at YouTube. Because there is a strong NoFap community on YouTube. Just like our boy, you know, future Matt Watson's in training, really. Got some fucking Rick and Morty game theory. We got, like, is that fucking... It's not rice gum. Why am I seeing French shit on my... It's like French rice gum. Okay. NoFap. What do we got? What do we got? Let's go by upload date. As you do, if you want the best content. NoFap story, I almost relapsed. Day 587, holy shit. And look at this thumbnail, oh my god. Okay. 587 days, guys.
So, 1 week ago, at day 580, I would almost relapse and just lose this amazing streak. This is today's story and today's topic, but before I continue, make sure to subscribe and click the bell notification.
Hit that fucking bell
for my newest uploads. Let's start. Now, everything started with my intention to again start opening my root chakra with the seed sound Lam, which every chakra has one. And this powerful sound Lam, by chanting it either Lam, 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 or Lam, like a very long prolonged.
Guys, what the fuck am I watching?
Long time?
I only had like a bowl and a half today, you know what I mean? Like, this is a bit too much.
I was doing this maybe for 30 minutes or more.
30 minutes?
And then...
Not a bully stream. Definitely not a bully stream.
Then I started feeling, first of all, kind of more grounded. And I saw this change in me that...
Yeah, this is a weird accent. I agree.
I wasn't so anxious.
It's like not specific. It's like French Arnold Schwarzenegger
outside,
with a bit of Indian scammer.
And I was feeling more grounded because this mantra is so powerful. But the negative effect
YouTube is stored in the balls.
Was that my sexual urges.
Urges.
This crave for sexual pleasures came into the surface. And I was tempted to go and to watch pornography or to masturbate. And I was thinking, is this from this mantra that I was chanting on or from one other meditation with frequencies that I've done? And probably it is this. And my advice is to, if you're working with the chakras, please don't start from the root chakra. Since I
said it was this wide.
I am on my spiritual journey for a few years.
Right,
I thought that
this guy just
to be fully open, balanced, and healed, for you to overcome your porn addiction and masturbation and sexual addiction. Now, after we work...
See, I agree with people in chat. This is not an unattractive man. I don't know. I guess it can happen to the best of us, but, like, I don't know. This doesn't feel like something that this man should be... You know, over and above being a fucking vegan, you gotta be, like, a NoFap guy. Like, what... What? There are religious people. There are devoutly religious people who fucking slap themselves in the back with a fucking strap every night because they're sinners just for living. Who have more fun than you, dude? What the fuck?
This
no meat,
heart chakra.
No meat.
Then we're going to
and
able
no meat.
To,
no meat and no yeet. You know that's horrible. All right. Well, that was less interesting than I thought. English version. No fap. 1 month. 1 month.
Let's get better.
All right. Well, what do we got? Let's get better, everybody. This guy's from India. This is a worldwide phenomenon, you know?
Hi, मैं गगन कुमार. आज मेरे NoFap challenge का एक महीना complete हो गया. मैंने पिछले महीने की 11 तारीख को NoFap challenge शुरू.
Why? Listen, I understand that it's maybe not a video meant for my demographic, but if it's not gonna be in English, then why is the title in English? You know, like, no fat boxing workout. What's going on here? 13 days challenge so far.
Hey, what's up, awesome people? This is Ashish, and in today's video, I'm gonna share with you some of the benefits which I have.
This man has a problem. Are you fucking kidding me?
Experience from this NoFap challenge. So guys,
it really can be anybody. See, I went into this thinking it would all be fucking people like the Necro Zoo guy or some shit. I figured it would all be like intensely weird weirdos, but like, so far I'm seeing some decent looking dudes. And I'm seeing an ideology that, outside of the couple of very strange guys who are taking it a little bit too far and talking about phoenixes and ashes and things like that, I can kind of get behind what they're going for. I mean, like, you know.
Aaj 13th din hai. 13th din. So guys, today is the 13th day, and main NoFap challenge kar raha hu pichle 13 dinon se. Aur iske bare mein mujhe mere cousin Rahul ne bataya tha. So guys, जब से मैं इस चैलेंज को कर रहा हूँ, तो
okay, so we're just abandoning English then. Okay, but you know, don't be surprised when your watch time metrics are fucked up, dude. You reel them in with the 20 seconds of English language commentary, and then you switch over to your other language, and suddenly half the world is like, oh well, I guess I have to go watch the boxing workout instead. What's going on here? Oh, plus.
Pussy Destroyer. Pussy Destroyer.
I cannot wait to get fucking content claimed for this. Okay, hang on. Hold the fucking fort. I guess we're not fucking... We're not archiving this one, then. Alright. Well, now we're doing silent shadow boxing, I guess. I hate this. TF. They are all insane. This feels like a TikTok video. Look at the mold. Oh, dang. Well. Oh, God, you're right. What the fuck, dude? What are you keeping in your closet? Oh, no. There's something going on in this man's closet. I don't like this. Uh-oh. He takes off his fucking shirt later. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I have no words, you know? I'm as silent as the video is right now. Okay. Well, there's your NoFap boxing workout. Perfectly relevant to whatever the fuck. Okay.
Right. Well, I have the desktop audio on. Yes, I do. Thanks. I just lost NNN. Yeah, I mean, everybody's gonna have fun. Y'all good? You good? Everybody? You good? We got the Illuminati show over here. I would like to watch this, but this man is kind enough to mention that it's in Hindi. Why are so many of these in Hindi? Oh, I hate to make a Bob's and Vagin joke, but T-Series already lords over everybody else in subcount, so. NoFap Day 84. Desafio NoFap caindo recomendado. Recomendando maíz. I don't know how to speak. Joe Rogan on NoFap. Oh, here's this fucking suck boy, cuck man, fucker. I hate that guy. Is peaking a relapse? NoFap benefits 2019 movie. It's a minute. It's 1 minute. It's not a movie.
NoFap benefit. I've got a deep voice. NoFap benefit. My eyes aren't all fucked up.
Benefit. That beard, though.
I no longer have to itch my nutsack. Better drinking choices, people.
See, this is the thing, is like, I don't know if I believe this shit, you know what I mean? Like, oh, it... I saw this earlier when I was looking into this, I was like... They were like, oh, NoFap helps your hair grow back and all this shit, and I'm like... Physiologically, that you know that this doesn't make sense. You understand this. Maybe you're doing it with the power of your mind, but I don't think it's actually helping your beard growth, dude.
I'm actually a clean person now.
More time to clean.
Well, what do you know?
What do you know?
Walk like a boss.
Alpha status. Oh my god. The funny part is when they say it without a hint of irony, too. Now I just need to go to the bathroom. Thanks, guy.
God, it's been like 4 hours and I still got this boner going on? Jesus. Why don't you just go down already?
Mark my words, ladies.
I do need to see a doctor.
Mark my words, ladies and gentlemen. This guy is going to... Look, his name is even Matt. He's going to be the next Matt Watson. It's going to happen. Vlog 1, day 27 only. NoFap, eating ice cream. How I got addicted to pornography. Tell us, Matt NoFap.
Alright, so, I wanted to make one last video in regards to my past history and where I've come from and my struggle with pornography addiction and where I came from And I don't mind opening up about this because I feel like if it wasn't for the person again who told me about this a long time ago, then I wouldn't be where I'm at now. And I always thought that maybe I once I heard from him, like when I was in Africa and this guy was telling me about it, like I wanted what he had, you know. He was like working
when
on his
PhD.
When he
was in Africa? What is the story here?
He was really smart.
This is exciting.
He was fit and active. He had a girlfriend at the time, which was something that I desired, and he was open and honest about his this whole NoFap thing.
Yeah, I bet you desired her, bud.
You know, I wanted what he had, so I thought, you know what, maybe I can try to do this. And for me, it all started when I think I was 10 or 11, and this is my story essentially. I
also do not know what a coomer is.
And I would always go to his house ever since I was a little kid, and you know, to hang out and sleep over. And he lived in Pomona, and I grew up in Claremont, and we went to the same elementary school. And when I went to his house, you know, we'd do different stuff. We'd play video games and, you know, like fool around with each other, and sometimes.
It always comes back to video games, like to Gideo Vames. Like it's all Japan's fault, I'm telling you.
Things random kids would do.
Video games and anime are the fucking source of the whole world's problems.
And his mom and his father had a big screen TV, a 65-inch screen, big screen TV. And one night we stayed up, and he said, "Let's go to the main TV room, and let's." I don't know what he said at the time, but he was like, "Let's watch this stuff." And I don't know if he said anything or if he just said, "Just come." And he turned on the adult cinema channels, you know. And that was the first time, and I can still remember all of those videos of these women and men, you know. And it was, I mean, even just remembering it, I wish that I could. I've told others this, like, if I'm at a meeting, sometimes I'll say this, and I'll say, like, I wish that I could just go back in time and go up to this kid who is 11 years old, who is being told about this pornography, these images and these video clips, huge video clips of these women. And this is like Playboy. It's pretty hardcore stuff.
And just to go up to him and say, "Hey, Lord, I wanted to hear his whole story." But like, at this point, it's like,
"I saw the porn and I was just so enamored by it. She had titties."
It's like, dude, at least tell me the story of the sexy sleepover, which we know you had. Everybody on V had one. We know you did too. But, okay, so. Reclaim your mind. Thoughts, Gangstar, NoFap, semen retention. Okay. This sounds like very exciting. You're not going to retain it for long if you wind up like that one guy. "Let me out! I need to leave! Oh, God!"
What's up? Kicks thoughts. How's everyone doing right now? I just got out of the gym. Feel good. NoFap and semen retention. Two different things. NoFap is basically guys trying to get off porn, which there's nothing wrong with that. That's totally fine. And I think semen retention is basically you're retaining your semen.
You're not.
You're holding it. You're not even wasting it on no girls. Nothing.
No girls. Nothing.
Gangstar in the gym. Song called Discipline. And there was a line that really grabbed my attention and said, "Most cats be thinking with their bow sack. Their ball sack." And like, that's so true, man. It's so true. Most guys are like, "Oh, I need to find a woman. That'll fix all my problems." No, dude. You gotta learn to love yourself first.
"Thou shalt not spill thine seed upon the floor of thy woman's mistress," whatever.
"I was trying to text you and wanting to hang out." Dude, think. Think before you act. That's my advice. Don't ever just say yes because you're desperate. Like, where is your value in yourself? Value yourself, man. You're the prized possession.
I do, and so is my nut.
Not woman bashing, man. I'm trying to figure out how men are, you know? You shouldn't focus on women because that'll make you more feminine. It's Keg's thoughts, because
this guy looks so fucking bitter. Like, wow.
I don't really know what other name to call my channel, you know? Because that's what, like, that's just how this video is right now. Like, I'm just talking. These are my thoughts right now. I don't know who.
See, this is the super energized face of a man who's gone, like, 187 days or some shit.
Journey. I hope you guys are too, man. I hope you guys haven't relapsed. Anyways, this is a quick short video. I just wanted to give some insight. Check out new Gangstar, though. They just released a new album there. It's pretty dope. Anyways, have a good day, guys.
Have a good day, dude. Avoid the rope, alright?
What is NoFap? 10-day benefits explained. NoFap gaming. Huh. I mean, those two do go together very well. NoFap, why nobody won't remember your name? Well, that's like a fucking triple negative. Legacy Kanye West porn. What the fuck is this?
So I think it's kind of funny.
Welcome to YouTube.
So, just kind of scrolling through my news feed on my YouTube channel. And you know how stuff always gets, like, recommended, right? So I decided to watch this, and it was like, why Kanye, you know, has a pornography addiction. And it's like, first of all, of how he started out, right? Big old egomaniac, you know, look at me, I need all this attention. Check out my Twitter account, my Facebook, you know, blah, 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 fucking noise, right? See, that's why I don't fucking listen to celebrities. I don't. It's just fucking noise. You know, they get to make all this money, get all the attention.
Someone in chat says, I almost forgot to unmute myself. Someone in chat says, have any of these dudes ever just thought about just nuts sometimes? Yeah. Why can't we just make it like a not addiction, but like, well, I guess technically you could say that about like drinking too, and it wouldn't be that great of an argument for drinking. So I don't know. This is an interesting debate, honestly. And no, I don't know what the fuck is going on with this man's head.
Attention and fame and fortune. Jealous? No. I don't want that. As a young boy, I thought I wanted that. I had a little taste of it. But it was just like, nah, I don't really want this. I'm more introverted than anything. A lot of people think, oh, hey, you're extroverted, blah, blah, blah. No, I'm actually the opposite. I don't like all of that attention.
Yeah, I can imagine that you're wearing this fucking thing on your head. I can imagine you don't want anybody around you.
I don't.
Probably working wonders.
From YouTube, right? So, some days, yeah, I might think I want that, right? I think I want it, but I know I don't want it. So, you know, all these celebrities, they get all this attention and fame and fortune. But yet, they cry out after they've made it, right? That white people saying, I've made it. I've did this. I've made it.
Hell yeah, that's white people. I heard they can talk to aliens.
I was watching the fucking video, and he was like, at 5 years old, you know, there was a Playboy in my room, you know, my dad.
Dude, that was literally the last video.
Same with me. My dad was a Playboy fanatic. Had tubs.
Don't worry, we'll get to female nomad.
Back in the 80s. Even before I was born, I bet you if I sold that, I could have made thousands of fucking dollars. Did I do that? No, I just threw it in the fucking trash. Yeah, Rubbermaid containers full of Playboys. So carrying on, celebrities.
They apparently, no nut is all money, right? Due to the celebrities. I think this guy is a bit of an exceptional individual. What's going on this man's channel? NoFap, the spark, discipline, goals, your self-reliance, self-power. You are not alone. Look at the way this man titles his videos. Look at this formatting. This is amazing. I should do this for my videos, too. Winter is coming. And so am I. Dark side, alcoholic mindset. Day 13, sobriety. This guy has always got something on his forehead. All right. Jesus. Vitamins, steam baths, the three genders. All right, female, no nut. Upload date, no nut in VR chat. I don't think female. NoFap.
Oh, baby. Huh.
Thank you for leading me down this wonderful path.
NoFap, women, attraction, benefits, expanse. That's a guy. I don't want to assume his gender, but, NoFap and female attraction. Let's be honest, it's mostly dudes. NoFap, female attraction. The real truth about NoFap. See, Woken Warrior here. This is who I trust. NoFap, female. So it's all just about how to pick up chicks. It's not a lot of actual chicks. And I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, but we are not sorting by most popular or any of the other shit. Date posted is the way to go. Because otherwise we don't get the real content. We get the shill liberal media content. Break the condition! So, NoFap female attraction is real. We're going to find us a nice lady. NoFap feminine POV from 2 months ago. So we had to go back quite a ways here. What does Kiana Lachey
have to say? What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Kiana Lachey. You know, it's so crazy how life works. And when you're paying attention, you'll start to realize how things are always working in your favor as long as you want them to. Now, for the longest, I've been seeing people comment on my videos saying, like, do a video on NoFap. And to be honest with you, I...
Thank you for your service, by the way, meme review.
I had no idea what they were talking about.
So meme review.
I went ahead and went to go educate myself on what they were talking
about.
Giving
us the news update bulletins in the chat.
A lot of things and a lot of practices that I do in my newfound journey here, my spirituality. I do so much stuff. Like, everybody doing this, right? It's a challenge, NoFap. But this is stuff that I do. Like, I've been doing that. And I had no idea that it was classified as something out here as NoFap. You feel me? So, y'all, I've been doing that. And I've noticed so much about myself, you know, from not abusing my sexuality. Because
so
that's basically
lady,
what it is.
This lady has, like, already been doing this. This lady has died in the wool. She's been doing this for years before... It became a meme. She was NoFapping before it went mainstream. This is the NoFap hipster.
Sin to abuse your sexuality.
Big round of applause. I know your hands aren't busy with anything else.
When you are low vibrational and you only know of this third dimensional realm, you don't see shit that way. And I don't feel that I'm better than anybody down there or down here that don't view what I'm viewing just yet. Because there's always opportunities within your obstacles. So... NoFap, something I've been doing, something I involuntarily was doing. I didn't even know it. I was getting so in tune with myself that I didn't have the energy to even think about watching pornography. And I've had, you know, my fair share, just like how a lot of y'all do, have your fair share with the addiction to porn. And how do you feel when you are doing these things? This is what I was talking about. When you are dealing with energy vampires and narcissistic people, how do you
oh my
feel
God,
when you
did
get
you
around
just
this
say energy
stuff?
Vampires
you
with a completely fucking
like
straight
when you're
face?
Watching porn for 3 hours.
So we got fapstronauts and energy vampires in the same fucking, like, in the same universe, in the same canon. This is great. Sounds like a James Bond movie.
Hours out your day.
One
because
of the later
you
ones.
Probably might not
Moonraker.
Anticipate to watch it for that long, but you're doing that for that long. And what are you gaining out of that? You are literally draining yourself of your energy because
someone in chat
you
named says that I think we went full circle to the black Israelites. We have not yet. That was going to be the other topic of discussion for the stream today. Apparently, I looked at a black Israelite on my gang stalking stream. And he responded to me, and he was like, I almost put a voodoo black magic curse on you, but you didn't have any negative energy behind your words or something. And then he actually talked about, like, Egyptians and kings and things, and that was amazing. But yeah, I narrowly avoided some black magic, ladies and gentlemen, so... that was going to be the topic of discussion, but I am not a bully stream, so... So never mind that. Let's
Let's proceed with
creative energy within you. That's POV. Why you in a mood to get it off, or that's why you, you know, whatever. But you don't realize that that energy you can take and transmute somewhere else. I started to realize that. I even started to realize that when I started to learn more about sex magic. And I have a video down in the description bar if you guys are interested, check it out. But, you know, we made up of all of this energy, whether people want to believe it or not. When you deny facts and you deny truth, you are essentially denying the Most High and you are denying yourself. It's just a part of us. I have this womb, right? And this womb, I have to be more careful, you know, handling. I can't abuse my sexuality. I can't give my body to pointless men. And it's something that I've been thinking about a lot. I get the urge sometimes, like I want to, you know, step out, do me. But I can't do that because it's something greater than me right now that is literally channeling through me. That is literally channeling through me, and I am recognizing that for what it is. Hopefully y'all understand what I mean by that. Like the night
semen
that,
demons, you're
oh,
right.
I really want to go and, you know, hit up so-and-so because, you know, he look good, you feel me? And I, but no, I can't do that. And it's like, I didn't got
so
to
we aren't
point.
Even just talking no like, fap, know, we're talking no anything.
Day, but you know what I mean.
Look
I'm,
at this.
I'm not
going
to say I'm at a point
unit.
To where, like, I don't think about having sex and I don't think about that, but I low-key am at a point in my life to where that's the last thing on my mind for real. I take that energy and I transmute it somewhere else. My self-love, my self-care, healing my chakras, getting to know myself even more. Because to know thyself, to truly know thyself, is to recognize
all of the
parts. We're breaking
up the thighs.
You can't just dismiss certain parts of you because you are not willing to admit that. You watching porn all of that time and you only being sexually attracted to people.
My cursor was moving to
like
the closed window button.
Sexual addiction, that's not healthy. That's not right. It's not right.
Yeah.
I don't like that. And
I don't like this
deep,
either.
Deep.
This is a boring fucking video. Well, I guess we got some idea about the female perspective, and this seems to be the only woman. Remember, this is sorted by date. Is it, actually? Yes, it is. Upload date. This is sorted by upload date. That was 2 months ago. And I'm not finding a fucking other one from a woman. NoFap relapse is inevitable. Ooh, baby. Fest. Who is this lady?
Hey, how's it going, everyone? So great to see you. Thank you all so much for being here. So today I want to talk about shame and guilt when it comes to relapse with porn and masturbation. I just got done having an awesome session with someone who felt super down on themselves and just super guilty for masturbating and watching porn again after going through a long period where they weren't doing that. And this is a really common theme amongst a lot of the people who come to see me for sessions, is that they end up relapsing and they just feel so bad about themselves. They feel guilty. They feel like ashamed of who
kind
they
of sessions
are. They
are we
feel
talking
like
about
they,
here?
They
listen, no. I'm sure this lady is a perfectly credentialed
you know, and it's
I was gonna say professional, but that sounds really bad.
And it's not like if you do NoFap for 90 days everything's just done like that. It just doesn't work like that. It's like 90 days. It's only 3 months, you know? That's only 3 months of time compared to the years and years and years that you've spent developing this habit, you know, and engaging in that habit. So, relapsing.
In fact, I'm going to go so far as to say that the playing with the hair is definitely not helping. Relapse is inevitable, motherfuckers. Okay, what else is going on in this lady's channel? I'm not gonna sit and watch this whole fucking video, because who cares? Why I always talk about porn? Oh, okay. Is she gonna teach us how to pomegranate our mans? Hi, everyone. Thinking about porn or other people during sex, is watching porn a form... Is it bad to have a small dick? How ejaculating is... From New Age to Jesus? Oh, boy. It's one of these... Okay, well... Thank you, Hana. I appreciate your... She's not even really talking about it from her perspective. She's just, like, helping people with it. I don't know. Maybe it's, like... I was gonna make some suggestions as to what the help might be, but I'm gonna move on from that. Let's move on from that, and let's look at NoFap hair thickness. Okay, yeah, this is what I mentioned before. Does it cause hair growth? Let's check out this guy. What does this guy have to say?
What's up, my NoFap bros? Man, I'm back again with another valuable informational update. Today I'm going to be talking about my thinning hair, the third update video about my thinning hair. And I've gotten to the point where I've accepted,
dude, you're blocked, who don't I worry. Am,
you know, good and the bad, you know, the flaws, even the things that I like about myself. I accepted myself, so... Me having thinning hair doesn't bother me as it did before. So, I don't even care if I have thinning hair. Before I cared, you know, I was looking at, you know, different herbs, different oils that
although
I could put
actually,
in my hair and
yeah.
take, you know, the herbs this, I could take to help promote, you know.
This man's hair, this man's head is, honestly, I think he'd look better without the hair that he has now. He should just. You know, at this point, just go full Lex Luthor, you know what I mean? Like,
you know, or to help stimulate those hairs to grow. Shape. You know, but now...
Come on. He kind of looks like Caius Cossades, or whatever his name is, from fucking Morrowind. He's got like a...
No, I'm not worried about it, so therefore it's not a problem. You know, so I'm okay with it, but this is my... This is my update. I haven't cut my hair in maybe about
you could eat cereal off of that hair.
3 weeks. 3 or 4 weeks, no, about 3 weeks. You know, I edged it up, you know, if you can see right here. And so this is my thinning hair. It looks like it's growing back a little bit.
What does this have to do with not fat?
This is not my original hairline. So let's get that straight. This is not my original hairline. I made this hairline up, you know, just so it can look decent. You know, so
okay,
that's how it looks. You know, so it's growing back thicker. If you can
so
see,
he put his he gave himself less hair to try it. No, buddy, I don't think it worked. Uh-oh.
See right here, it's black. Even my beard is thicker. You know, right here, the top of my head. You know, this
dude,
is when
like,
I was a baby.
Just leave the hair. Just get rid of it. It's fine. You'll look fine. You will look 100% better than you do right now. Okay. Well, good luck on that. It was a couple years ago, but let's go by upload date. What's going on in the NoFap hair thickness community? We got this guy. Is this a lady? I don't know. Just looks like one. What's going on here? This is from fucking last year.
What's up, guys? Today I'm going to be showing you, again, NoFap hair regrowth. So, okay, first of all, I want to say this. There's a bigger benefits than your hair growing back. I mean, yeah, it's cool to think about that and be like, you know, but there's bigger benefits than that. I'm talking a whole lifestyle change. I'm talking a life change with this NoFap. And so... I encourage you to think about it like that. Don't just think about the benefits. I mean, I've seen, heard about people getting NoFap hair regrowth, but really focus on, you know, what other bigger benefits are there. You know, what are some of the bigger picture? What's the bigger picture? You know, in regards to quitting pornography and masturbation and. You know, I want to see you thriving. I want to see you,
you know,
growing. And the way to do that, there's a few different
like
things I want to share.
From Splatoon, fucking no nut.
One is set boundaries for yourself. If you're doing NoFap and you're trying to do this, really set boundaries. No phone in the bathroom. No phone in your room. Things like that. Simple things like that. As well as getting accountability software. There'll be a link in the description for Covenant Eyes. Like I said, think about the bigger benefits, like
you can't just fucking have more joy,
more better relationships, more fulfilled, all that stuff from quitting this thing. And really, instead of
this poor lad, really desperate. Look at this. I'm sorry, sir. I am not trying to bully you right now when I say this, but man, you, the sadness in your eyes, I'm floored, like, you really, really hope that this thing, that this NoFap business will, like, help you with your life, and I just don't think it's gonna happen, I feel like it's just not gonna happen. I feel like that's not the path to enlightenment, It might help you with some things, but it's not gonna, like, it's not gonna fix everything. Guy probably lives on crystals and herbs like the rest of the sheep of his kind. Wow, okay. I don't know. I'm not sure what you mean by that, Twiggy the giraffe, but those are some heated words. Yeah, I'm not trying to bully this lad. These are some, I know I'm saying some spicy stuff right now, but goddamn. That is a colon D expression if I've ever seen it. Or rather D colon. Colon D is the good one. Yeah. This is unfortunate. He's just putting so much stock into his, like, this hope that this'll, like, help him. 30-day no porn challenge.
Welcome, guys.
This guy's whole how to stop masturbating addiction. How to quit porn and masturbation. Alright, well, let's see what his last video is like.
Video.
The last one was like a year ago, and it was talking about the benefits of the hair. The
I will show you exactly how to quit porn and
masturbation. I'm
masturbation. So porn and masturbation, it's a very...
I'm gonna say that the benefits of the hair growth have not kicked in yet.
Very hard habit to quit because all of us want that sexual gratification, but it takes discipline, like Cosmo, right? Obviously, to get over this addiction. So,
I don't think you're over the addiction, dude. I think you've just supplanted it with this other giant thing in your life that's, like, getting in your way probably in most facets of everyday life, I would imagine. This is really not healthy, my good sir.
One tip I can give you is to have a purpose, have a vision, have a mission to what you're doing. You don't want to just be going around just like, not doing anything. It's very, very important to have something you're pursuing, not be bored. Boredom is the enemy, as I say. So that's one tip. Yeah. Another tip is to exercise. When you're feeling the urge, go to the gym or just do some push-ups. That's going to release dopamine, endorphins, and just make you feel really good. All right. So that's pretty much how to quit. Those are two tips. Click the link in the description for a lead magnet. For a free report. God bless. Have a great day.
What? Are you okay? I don't think this is helping. Oh God. Okay, that's enough of this guy. In fact, I'm going to call it for the stream because we've gone about 2 hours now. And, oh God, my bear is missing. Oh God, I'm dead. There I am. That'll about do it for the NoFap community. Some decent points, I guess. Some very interesting people, though. And, I don't know. Decide for yourself, ladies and gentlemen. What does the chat have to say? NoFap is for incels addicted to porn. I mean, possibly definitely some of them, yes. But that's not necessarily everybody. We saw some dudes in the video who were, like, pretty attractive guys. We saw some women who were pretty attractive who were, like, doing this stuff. So, I don't know if we can say that it's, like, incels. I don't know if we can attribute it to, like, Elliot Rogers in the chat, but yeah, no nuts, please. This is so sad. It was fun while it lasted. It's over. I'll take a look at the super chats here. We got $5 from DBZFan22. You gotta have balance in life, he says. Obsessing about NoFap but not trying to fix other key life problems is just as bad. Your vids are awesome, bro. Thank you so much, sir. I agree. Supplanting the NoFap thing, or supplanting the porn addiction with, like, all of this, like, fervent, you know, support or whatever of this weirdo thing is, I don't know. I don't think that's healthy. Let's do some music. Hang on. What do I got here? I got some fucking Sonic Heroes music, sure. Keep that on low. 2 pounds from Lewis West. He just says, yowie wowie. I agree. If there's one takeaway from this stream, it's probably both yowie wowie and penis. Although less penis at this point in time. Oh god, is the music too loud? It might be too loud. We'll find out. Spooky Nerdy Skellington with, oh no, wait, hang on. Ryan Marie with $2. No message. Thank you very much, sir. DBZFan22 with $2. Guy with no shirt looks like a video from 2006. Yeah, it's pretty special. Spooky Nerdy Skellington with $2. Look up the Covenant Eyes ad, the NoFap app. The NoFap app? Okay. Okay, Covenant Eyes ad. What the hell is this? Is this the abstinence software? Covenant Eyes ad is, oh, okay. All right. Well, shit. We will return to super chats momentarily, ladies and gentlemen, because this is some shit. The Covenant Eye. Why is there 1.3 million views? Uh-oh. This is going to be
spicy.
Every
superhero has strengths and weaknesses.
Scorch Man.
Strength, fire. Weakness, fire extinguisher.
Catman.
Strength, always lands on his feet.
Okay, that's an actual weakness, superhero.
Laser pointers.
Hamster Man.
Strength, he's in a giant hamster ball. Weakness, he's in a giant hamster ball.
And there's me.
Colossal Man.
Superpower. Strength. My weakness?
What?
Porn.
Oh, boy.
Bet you didn't see that one coming.
No one ever does.
This is my buddy Jeff.
Yeah, but you can call me Wingman.
You can call me... You know what? I'm not even going to say
it. I can fly.
YouTube
I'm just
guidelines.
So, just call me Jeff.
Just Jeff.
Just Jeff.
Some people feel like porn doesn't negatively affect them, but if you're like me and you've struggled to get away from it, here's how I did it. All right, so my story, I was 12 years old the first time I saw Porn Night.
Oh, no.
Is he gone? Yeah, think of Porn Night like an alluring purple rock.
You know how much most of you probably hate Modern Family? I don't mind Modern Family. I think it's kind of delightful. This is like really shitty Modern Family.
Why, this stuff was so intoxicating. I found myself looking at it more.
Oh, kill me.
More. I hated the way it made me feel. I felt hopeless. For years, no matter what I did, I couldn't get away.
Hetero life.
Finally, I realized, even though I'm the strongest man in the world, I wasn't strong enough to quit porn alone. I needed someone to help me. I needed an ally. And that's when I found Covenant Eyes.
Powerful
Covenant
male
Eyes
ally.
Is software for all
we
your devices that actually helps you quit porn. The difference is having an ally to help you in the fight. Why is porn so difficult Covenant to fight eyes, alone? Huh? The shame cycle. When we look at porn, we feel shame, which
why,
leads to
though?
Isolation.
Why, what is wrong with you that you feel shame? Like, all starts over again. Like, I look at some fucking weird shit from time to time, and I don't feel shame from it. Like,
the best way to break this cycle is to remove the shame and isolation by opening up to a friend, which is exactly what Covenant Eyes helps us do. Here's how it works. Covenant Eyes can detect when porn is viewed. After you've struggled, Covenant Eyes creates a report of your activity. Then it sends that report to an ally of your choosing. Someone who supports
Boomer
you,
propaganda.
But not porn, like a good friend or a sibling.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Jeff. Are you aware that apparently NoFap is like an alt-right thing? This is what the Boomer news media wants to have you believe. the fucking Rolling Stone is running this article about how, like, porn, NoFap is, like, the alt-right thing. I don't even know. I'm not sure. I don't know, but, they're probably not 100% wrong, because I'm sure some of the incels who are a part of it are going to be, like, falling into that demographic. But I saw more normal, well-adjusted people today than weirdos, so I don't know.
This Covenant Eyes report lets your ally know that you need their help. And this connection to a friend takes you out of isolation and gives you the hope and encouragement you need to win the next battle.
Bro?
And after
you need
a while,
an ally.
Just knowing that Jeff would see my report gave me the strength to resist.
Are you fucking
kidding
me? When
Chris asked me to be his ally to help him with this porn thing, I was like, dude.
Dude. I love this. That was good. Dude, listen. Stop calling me every 5 minutes about how much you want to look at E621. I don't fucking care, dude. Fucking yiff. Go for it. Fuck. Dude, for fuck's sakes, it's been an hour. You're back on Letterotica again? Holy shit, dude. Those stories are from like 25 years ago. What is wrong with you? Most of those people are dead. Jeff. Oh, no, he's Jeff. Never mind. Chris.
Yeah, man. This is some interesting shit.
I'm messing with you, man. I was like, of course, man!
Asking Jeff to be my ally took me out of the shame cycle. And I finally felt like I could win this
shame
fight.
Shame cycle,
like,
right.
Boom! I just destroyed you, shame cycle. Like I destroyed Chris's bathroom.
What?
I'm just messing.
Okay.
Seriously, don't go in there.
After using Covenant Eyes, nearly 80% of users reported feeling hopeful and motivated that they can quit porn. Covenant Eyes works.
Yeah, it's like a flare gun.
Wait, what?
It automatically goes off, signaling that you need their help.
At least the production values are high.
But unlike a flare gun, not Covenant good. Eyes notifications are discreet and private. And
why is it so long?
Yeah, that one's on me.
So if you look at porn and you want to not look at porn, go to covenanteyes.com and download the app today.
Why don't you
That's
just
you
have
do.
Some fucking self-control?
I'm holding a car.
Listen, okay.
How did
okay,
Covenant
listen,
Eyes affect Chris?
Listen, okay.
More like, how did it affect us? We
call
started
me,
to rebuild the trust in our relationship.
Call me a fucking boomer, coomer, McZoomer, loomer, whatever. I don't care, but can we not have technology replace like you know, willpower? Self-esteem, like, self-control, do we need technology to replace that? Can't we just have those things? Can't we, like...
He stopped hating himself, he became...
You're married to this lady, and you're looking at...
...more
okay.
confident, and our relationship felt more honest and connected. Overall, it made a huge difference in our marriage.
And she never gets annoyed with me anymore.
Kind of.
Right there?
Yep, perfect.
All right.
I think he meant annoyed less.
After just a few weeks, it was crazy how much less power porn had over me and how much more confidence I had.
One trip. Yeah?
That's very impressive.
Yeah?
Without porn in my life, I became a better version of myself. Over 1 million people
He was very successfully
have used
able to pretend
to
that he was still in love with his wife while actually having a sordid love affair with Jeff on the side.
Porn. So why not you?
Thanks, Covenant
Eyes. They've
said,
after a 10-year addiction, I've been porn-free for more than 3 years now. Not only does it help me keep my eyes and my mind clean, but it has helped my marriage grow stronger. This app has been a game-changer.
Hey, maybe I should try this.
Seriously.
The guy's making a lot of sense. He's really speaking to me.
Getting away from porn improved every aspect of my marriage. Like, every aspect, if you know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
Porn isn't easy to talk about. I get it. And anyone can struggle with it, even a superhero. So that's why I wanted to share my story. And now with Covenant Eyes, I'm winning the fight against porn every day. Look, go to covenanteyes.com today and sign up with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Then ask one of your friends to become your ally. I know that's a scary thing to do, but trust me, being free of porn is worth it. You're not alone in this fight, so stop trying to fight it alone.
Look, Chris, I know I helped you quit porn, but... That's a lot of plates. I mean, if you drop this, you a dead man. I'm useless. I could call 911.
All right. Well, I think that'll about do it. We were going to quit before, but
we got sucked back in by the allure of the Covenant Eyes ad. Thank you for suggesting that, spooky, nerdy Skellington. And let's continue with wrapping this bad boy up. Continue with the super chats here. Horse with $2. Are we gonna do DDD too? Like DDD December? I'm down for that. Voldemort with $2. Claw, will you perform Yif magic upon us, please? I'm sorry, but I will repeat for the n-thousandth time. I like Banjo-Kazooie, man. I don't want to fuck Banjo-Kazooie, you know what I mean? Like, I'm sure we'll get to some epic furry cringe at some point soon. Smegma on Demand has super chatted $2. What was the last thing you faped to? I'm gonna assume you meant fapped. My hot girlfriend. Okay. Mia Smith with $20 and no comment. The absolute unit. And then another $10 from Mia Smith. Don't nut for the Smurfs. That's some good advice for us all. Jay Dethier Lowe. Thank you so much, Mia Smith. Jay Dethier Lowe with £2. Batman, have you been looking at porn again? I don't know which character is supposed to be saying that, but I just went for like a mix of Alfred and the Joker. I think it worked. $5 from Carlos Rodriguez. Can we get a shout out to the Johnson & Johnson company for providing great shampoo? Yeah, dude, good job, Johnson & Johnson. You are the guys. You are the Johnsons that I want in my life. All right. That'll about do it for the stream, you know? Thanks for stopping by. Oh, yeah, we had outro music before. Hang on. We were going to do some fucking Sonic, some weirdo Sonic. You know, I don't know why we... Hang on. Yeah, let's go with this.